Bonuses like this can only hasten your destruction. I intend to crush the enemy's outlying base here. I have commanded an attack at this position. So bold, but they do not expect me to attack here. My explorer has returned. Now the enemy shall pay for his insolence. This treasure has already been invested in the weapons I will use to demolish your puny nation. Congratulations in so effectively looting this new world. Ah, good. You are making fine use of your scouts. This will get its own room in the Tsar's palace. See what I have found. I am gaining wealth for both of us. Such a discovery is unique. Surely you have nothing like it. Sir, hands off the discoveries near my town. They are for me, stealing my treasure. I suppose we are on the same side, aren't we? Excellent. You are already on your way. I was hoping to capture the first treasure. But I am just as happy that it is you. You are skilled at gathering treasures. Keep it up. Go ahead, scavenge while you can. Your greed in taking the treasures does my old heart good. Do not leave all the work in making discoveries to me. You need to gather your fair share. Don't you want some of the treasures too? I took this treasure since you had not bothered to do so yourself. Too busy, no doubt. You did not need this treasure, obviously, since otherwise you would have taken it by now. Your men rummage through the brush like rodents, looking for tasty tidbits. Soon I bring a bayonet for you to bite on instead. My explorer will not be useful for a time. When he returns, I shall punish him severely. My explorer is incapacitated. Fortunately, it is only temporary. My explorer has failed us both. He shall pay. We are doomed. Doomed! Why do you force us to fight on? Our armies are scattered, our towns destroyed, our hopes dashed. But though no hope is left, we shall never surrender. Never! Do you hear our enemies? You will have to hunt us down and kill us one by one. You gather loot like a vulture instead of soaring like the Russian eagle. Use this coin to advance our great cause. Here is good hearty Russian food to fortify your nation. The endless taiga of Russia is filled with trees. Here is wood from it to boost your might. I will not let the foe destroy this building. My men will die rather than let this post fall to the foe. This native village is ours. I shall keep it for us. My men will garrison this town. This trading post belongs to us and us alone. I shall not relinquish it to the enemy. I can send coin to you for as long as you need it. I will keep a stream of rations coming to you as long as you require it. My woodsmen will send lumber so long as you lack it. War to the hilt! Let us combine our forces to destroy the enemy here. The Russian bear shall hold sway here, and you too, should you accompany me. Now is the time to unleash the dogs of war. Onwards, soldiers of Holy Mother Russia! Soon I shall hold sway over these natives instead of our hated foe. When I wreck this trading post, the enemy will no longer have his native friends to shelter behind. Our foe does not deserve the benefits of trade. I shall wreck his post here. Cutting off the enemy's resources is as effective as killing his soldiers. I am going to strangle him by destroying this trading post. My empire expands. I shall build a forward base of operations at this site. I have commanded a base to be made here to menace the enemy. You are off to a quick start, but the outcome is not in doubt. I am creating a town center here. My empire will expand by constructing a new town at this place. I need more territory under my control. I will construct a town here. I am adding these natives to our empire. Native soldiers will swell the ranks of my army. Such talent at killing bandits and wild animals. We will see how you do against my disciplined army. I want to have natives among my troops. I see I need the benefits of trade. Gold is as good a weapon as a sword, sometimes. By occupying a trading site, I can lure out the enemy's forces. I am going to hit them where they are weakest. They're settlers. Your lack of skill at treasure hunting probably demonstrates that you will be surprised by the size of my army. Without resources, their army withers on the vine. I am off to kill their settlers. The Tsar of all the Russias thanks you for your help in bringing back our explorer. I am pleased by your efforts on our behalf. I am not ungrateful for your assistance. Curse the enemy! He has forced me to ransom my explorer. That treasure was mine! You will regret this, little one. The only thing worse than sending gold to the enemy is not having my explorer here where I need him. The foe's puny efforts to deny us the use of my explorer have utterly failed. He is back. As usual, the enemy's plans have been thwarted. My explorer has returned to health. Our enemy is trying to get native help. I trust it will avail him nothing. Even the natives won't be able to save our foe from his destined doom. I gather treasure where I please, because I know you cannot stop me. Look at this, an enemy town, but with no defending army. A meaty prize, if you can take it. The enemy does not realize we know about this town. It is devoid of protection. Let us burn it to the ground. The fool! He has built a town without a barracks. Send in the cavalry! No barracks. He cannot produce infantry here. Attack quickly, before he realizes his blunder. He has no stable in this town. Our artillery can bombard it with impunity. Your primitive town structure is proof of your incompetence. Your soldiers will still be using sticks and knives while mine have gunpowder. I see he has no stable here. Attack at once with a barrage. They have killed my explorer. No mercy for the villain. Those knaves have killed my explorer. It is an insult to us both. What an offense against nature. Those poltroons have assassinated my explorer. This wilderness has killed my explorer. Your high technology will remain but a bittersweet memory when my Cossacks burn your town. What a deadly place this new world can be. It's put paid to my efforts to scout for the time being. My explorer! No! You cannot defeat me alone, so you seek native allies. They will do you no good in the end. This town is a ripe plum for the taking. Now I know where you are hiding. Your town shall be my prey. Your age advancement is too little, too late. Could you not see how near your ally was? You built practically on his doorstep, leaving the entire rest of the map for me to exploit. You are doing so well, my friend. Perhaps this means you can spare a few resources for me to age up as well. Now that you have access to more powerful troops, my role must temporarily be that of support. I will not be able to age up as quickly as you have done. You are still in the previous age. I hope you know what you are about. Such speedy advancement in age means you are neglecting military production. You shall learn the hard way how wrong your priorities are. Hurry and age up! You need to catch up to me. A fine job of advancement. Do not forget you will need troops to go along with your new upgrades and researches. Leaping up in age. Good, good. Put your technological edge to good use. At last, we will not have to endure the contempt of our foes any longer. You certainly took a long time to get to Colonial. I trust that means you have a huge army waiting somewhere. Do not take it too hard when my men raise your fine new buildings. Do you need some kind of help? You are still not Colonial. What is the problem? You cannot build a good army in the Discovery Age. I see you are still in the previous age from me. Have you even discovered gunpowder yet? Speed in advancement to colonial age will not matter in the long run. It is about time you reach colonial. Now you can train a few troops before I devastate your countryside. While you progress in age, I sharpen my saber. A blade through the heart kills even the most advanced soldier type. It is astounding that anyone could advance through the ages so slowly. Your luck will not hold. Yes, you have acquired the first treasure, but the bulk of the rest will fall to me. Pick up nuggets while you can. When my soldiers march into your town, it will be too late. I have vastly more loot than you. My army and economy will also be vaster than yours. Your town is so feeble, you cannot even stop me from looting nearby treasure. My armies will crush you with their superior technology. I cannot afford to do that. Yet. You will have to wait. Please ask again later. I have no money, so I cannot assist you. I do not have an army yet, or I would rush to your aid. You will have to fight on your own for the nonce. I cannot help. I see your town. I can already hear my armies march down your streets. Wait until I build an army. Soon I will have a mighty army, but not yet. My army is not yet large enough to help you. I am not prepared to attack the enemy yet. Yes, brilliant. Your towns are so close, like little lambs huddled together in fear. At once, of course. That action is forbidden to me. I am not able to follow your orders. Yes, artillery to demolish his buildings, plus a few horsemen to run down his settlers. You have rashly isolated your town. I can now crush you and your ally piecemeal. Artillery fortified by my sturdy infantry should be well nigh unbeatable. Yes, artillery. An unstoppable barrage of cannonball. With enough cannon, we can sweep the enemy away. We Russians are good at training cavalry. Perhaps this is a job for my Cossacks. And of course, some artillery to knock down any annoying infantry that might get in our way. Horsemen to trample the foe beneath their hooves. Plus some infantry to clean up anything that survives. I have saved my explorer. Now I shall punish you for his temporary captivity. I shall train infantry. Infantry and a few artillery pieces for show. Hordes of infantry is what we Russians are best at producing. A few cavalry to fill in the cracks, and we will have a fine force. Endless waves of horsemen from the steppes will be a fine sight. Cavalry are the answer to our problems. You are right. I need more infantry. One can never have enough. Yes, you wounded my explorer, but now he is back and thirsting for revenge. I shall train an endless horde of infantry. Ha! A free settler. You are rich. Food is always welcome. You know, free warriors like that make excellent cannon fodder. You may have caught my explorer, but you could not keep him. Even lowly wood can be put to use in your war machine. Hurrah! I got a free settler. Gold here for the taking. This new world is a land of plenty, overflowing with food. That was a nice bonus for my army. The natives are foolish to ally with your cause. I am glad I found this wood before the enemy. That is the kind of battle I like. Lots of action, and in the end, myself victorious. A close-fought struggle, but in the end, my will proved the stronger. A balanced fight. Either side could have won. But I did. They never had a chance. Is that your army? It is so small. It must be a decoy. I just rolled right over them. Ha ha! I love it when a battle goes smoothly. These walls will stop almost anything. Ha! Let the enemy try to come through these walls. Quickly, we must destroy one of the enemy posts or all is lost. That force seems too big for a band of scouts. You must think it is an army. Curse their eyes. The enemy has 4 trading posts. They cannot win by main strength, so they are trying to do so with cunning. Building 4 posts is not the most glorious way to win a war, but it is certainly effective. They have to come to us now to keep us from winning. Let us prepare an ambush. I see that you have been effective in multiplayer lately. It gives me confidence that we shall conquer today. Your multiplayer rating is up from last time we played. It is good to have a competent ally such as yourself. You are letting your men wander too far from home. Did they lose their way? I see by your multiplayer score that you have been having trouble lately. Well, perhaps this fight will turn things around for you. Your multiplayer rating makes it clear that you have been suffering defeats. Do not dwell on the past. The future belongs to us. I see by the size of your home city that you have done some growing up. Excellent. How strong your home city looks this time. I am impressed. We were here last time. I guess we know the ins and outs of this map by now. I see your army. Sadly, it's not large enough to merit concern. Don't let me down like you did last time. This time for sure, victory or death. Hurrah! It is you again. Last time we won, and that bodes well for this time. Thank you for being the backbone of our army last time we were allied. This time, I vow to be stronger. Do not make me do all the work like last time. I have spotted your invasion force. Now I can cut it off and destroy it. You taught me a hard lesson last game. See how well I've learned from your example. Do not worry. I will be just as aggressive on your behalf as I was trying to defeat you. Those knaves! Let us seek immediate retribution upon their bodies. They will pay for their insolence. The foe may have gotten the first native alliance, but they will not have the last one. Why are you just sitting there? The enemy has a native alliance, and we do not. There you are. Bring on your puny assault. I am ready. Ah, the enemy has a trading post. That should be a juicy nugget for our raiders. An enemy trading post, already. They are more competent than I thought. They keep getting more native allies. This gives us more juicy targets to pick from for our attacks. Our foe seems very interested in trade. Perhaps that indicates he would lose spirit if we were to strike at them. Yes, a never-ending stream of native warriors. I see your invading army. So large, your home base must be defenseless. With the wealth we earn from trade, we can bury our foes. Good, good! Now that we have native allies, let us train as many as possible before the enemy does something about it. The enemy are slow and weak. That is why we were able to conquer this trade route first. The enemy's attempt to defeat us with their puny four-of-a-kind has been crushed under my boot heel. With these native warriors, I can swamp my foe by sheer numbers. Your large but undisciplined mass of soldiers does not frighten me. Money greases the wheels of warfare. That is what this trading post is for. If one native ally is good, more are better. If one trading post is good, more are better. This fight may be tougher than the last one, but I am tougher too. I see you have decided to face weaker opposition than last time. That is fine. I have nothing against massacres. I see you are hoping to invade me. I must stop you cold. Only 1 minute! Inconceivable! Attack! 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 For we are at the critical moment! Ha! We have them by the short hairs now. 1 minute left before our enemy's total humiliation. Just 1 short minute and the game ends. Our foe is doomed, and it is all because of our power. I have crushed our common foe's attempt to subvert the natives. What pleasure to see his town crumble as his peasants try hopelessly to flee. Attacking my settlers? You will pay for this. I love raising towns. It's what I do best. I have ruined his trading route. My troops have been repulsed by his defenses. Temporarily. I cannot believe I did not destroy his native alliance. What has gone wrong? His town still stands, but at least we hurt him. Apparently, your men are only good against unarmed civilians. Well, it was only a trading post. Nothing too critical. That action is totally impossible. Hurry, hurry! Rescue my people here! A disaster is in the brewing. We must rush all available troops to this place. Do not kill all the enemy before I get there. My economy is powerful enough to withstand your pinpricks. Save some for me. I want to kill some of them too. My men are rushing to your side. Keep fighting. We are almost there. Do not worry about how many men you lose. My men will replace your fallen. Just worry about how many of them you slay. With me by your side, we will drive off the enemy in confusion and defeat. This isn't right. The war was supposed to be in your town. Excellent. A worthy ally. Our foes have no chance. In trying to prepare my unstoppable army, I have neglected my economy. I need some coin right now to rectify affairs. Quickly, some coin, if it will not cripple you. My men cannot fight without food. Do you have any you can lend to me? My supply lines are barren of food. I need it badly. What are you doing? How can you be here? No! Without more wood, my progress will stop indefinitely. Do you have some? I have a wood shortage. Kindly send some along. Sound the war cry! Charge! Onward, my soldiers! No quarter! Death! Death to all who would stand in our way! You cannot take the credit for this victory. I'm sure I was betrayed by my own jealous underlings. Your men came in the nick of time. Together, we put the enemy to flight. We teamed up to rout the foe. Now let us take the battle to his base. So shall all our enemies die. Now we have them on the run. Keep attacking. This may not be the end, but it is at least the beginning of the end. Look at them take to their heels, the cowards. I know just how to spend this. With this shipment, I can prepare a mountain of pain for the enemy. My men will eat well tonight. I can use this wood for many things, all of which will harm our foe. Surrender now to avoid the humiliation of being utterly crushed. I hate advising anyone to retreat, but in this case, I think it is the wisest course. Save your troops for a fight you can win. This battle is lost. You need to send the enemy flying with cannonballs. Roll out the artillery. Artillery is the god of war. Forge more cannon. Flash your sabers above the foe. Gallop to the charge. You'll need many more horsemen than now. We will crush every inch of your civilization under our boots. The enemy cannot stand up to a charge. Send in the cavalry. I see that you need to train and equip some first. How can you massacre the enemy with volleys of gunfire or mass bayonet charges if you do not have any infantry? Don't you have some kind of building you can use to train infantry? You clearly need far more of them. I detest the thought of surrendering to these rascals. Can you see anything else we might try? I see no hope ahead, no sun on the horizon. This defeat chokes me like gall. But what else can we do but resign? My sword rusts from disuse. Are you ever going to attack? We are going to have peace, even if we have to fight for it. Wars never hurt anybody, except the people who die. We train our men not simply to endure battle, but to long for it. Charge! Die, poltroon! Enjoy the lull. My troops train diligently while you idle away your future. Feel my steel! I see I will have to fight all the harder. I do not need gold to finish you off. Food? I sneer at it. Wood and coin drive my war machine. Another warrior for my men to kill. Are you still there? Wood, what a useless resource. See how my population swells. This coin is being used to buy powder and shot, which will be fired directly at you. This food is being used immediately to train soldiers to attack your puny base. Free soldiers, the best kind. This wood will be used to construct blockhouses to train my army. That is the way I like fights. Bloody, straightforward, and ending with me on top. You never stood a chance. Curse you! I thought I had you that time. How did you pull that off? Your army was all but defeated. We have not fought for quite a while. Did it take that long to steel yourself to the task of attempting to defeat me? We have not met one another for some time, but it seems from your multiplayer rating that your skills have not improved much. Your home city is a lot bigger than the last time we met. Do not think it will save you. I liked this map the last time we played. It is a good map. I can defeat you, even if you have made the situation more favorable to you than our last encounter. You are doomed. You have foolishly made me your enemy. You would settle for the kind of puny victory you get by waiting out the timer? I am almost ashamed to be fighting you. You think just because a few ragged native tribes have joined your side, you will be able to field a more effective army? Well, perhaps you are right. Your multiplicity of trade routes shows that you waste your time on trivialities. I stick to the essentials. Ha! I knew you wouldn't be able to pull it off. Now the real fight begins. What? My native allies? You will pay for this. How can you fight on when I am able to destroy your town centers as I please? Ah, I love the smell of burning trading posts. My native warriors can easily trounce yours, especially since you do not have any yet, you fool. This trade route will carry my nation directly to your vulnerable heart. Building walls, I see. You are wise to fear me. A true soldier never walls in. You won't hold that native village for long. I will see to that. You may have built on the first trade route, but you have not built the last. What? My native allies? You will pay for this. I needed that trading post. You will be sorry you attacked it. My town! No! Too bad. Now I will have to crush you the old-fashioned way. By raising the difficulty since last time, you have unleashed powerful Russian forces you did not expect. Weakling, I see you needed to play at a feebler difficulty level. This indicates that I should have an easy victory over you. Ha ha! The final nails in your coffin are being hammered in right now. I have not lost yet. It is all over but the victory parade now. Ha! Trying to steal my loot, huh? I have taught your thieving troops a lesson. Your puny effort to raid my town is futile. Your men seem to lack direction. Where are they going? Your explorer cannot remain concealed from me. It will be a pleasure to crush you beneath my boot heel. This kind of a fight suits me just fine. Lots of wild action. Spread death, my men. Good, good. Wall in! That will free up extra troops that you can take to the enemy's town. Those walls should stop all but the most vigorous enemy assault. The British are no better than dead dogs by now. The British soldiers are strong. Perhaps too strong. Soon, we will be able to finish off the Netherlands contingent. The Dutch fight like demons. The French are helpless before us. The French are a dangerous foe. We must be ready for them. We Russians have long hated the Germans. It feels good to see them going down before us. We Russians have long hated the Germans. It is like drinking poison to see them doing so well. We have almost wiped out the Ottomans. If only getting a warm water port for Holy Mother Russia would be so easy back in Europe. We Russians have been fighting the Turks for centuries. Who knows better than us how difficult they are to beat? A few more hammer blows and the Portuguese will be out of this game. The Portuguese. I had never dreamed that such a small nation could hold such dangerous soldiers. Ha! Now we see at last who is the real Tsar of all the Russia. It is too bad that we are opposed by my brother Russians. It makes the fight less of a massacre than I prefer. I knew the Spanish would not prove much of an obstacle. The Spanish are so effective on the battlefield. Perhaps we should be focusing better on them. The cursed enemy has somehow amassed superior forces. Hurry, send help! Our war is in a downward spiral. Even your strength may not be enough to counteract my weakness. The cursed British! Can nothing stop them? The enemy advance on every front, but the British foe is not so strong as the rest. Let us destroy him, at least. Russia is so much vaster than the Netherlands. How can the Dutch be winning? If we do nothing, we lose. Let's hit the Dutch hard and fast and see if things look better. The French seem everywhere at once. What can I do against such skill? We may not win, but let us strike back. The French are our foe's weak spot. Strike! The Germans. Always invading Russia. Well, Russia may lose this war, but first, let us invade the Germans for a change. Blunderer. Knave. Not just your empire, but my own has been destroyed by your clumsiness. Resign at once, you poltroon. I am better off without your bungling. The hated Turks. There are too many of them. At least we can go down fighting. The war does not go well, but the Ottomans are not the ones beating us. Let us crush the hated Turks before the end. How can a nation as puny as Portugal be so strong in war? It seems inconceivable. Portugal is a small nation, and I hope weak. Let us aim our blows at them for now and see where it leads us. I should have known better than to take on Russia as my enemy. The war does not go well, but at least I have proven stronger than the enemy Russians. Let us at least strike them down before the end. Spain is far from Russia. I had never encountered them before, and neither had my troops. I am dismayed by their prowess. I do not like the way this is going, but perhaps there is hope if only we can destroy the Spanish. They seem vulnerable. We should have crushed them sooner. Now they have called on their friends for help. Yet another army. This may be too much for even me to handle. Now that your men fight alongside mine, we can turn the battle's tide and crush the foeman beneath our boot heel. Excellent. Now that our armies have joined up, the enemy has no chance here. Hurrah! The enemy is in retreat. Now we shall strike while the iron is hot. Now we have them where we want them. Attack! 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 Now we have the power to win this war. No mercy. We still have the edge in this war. No thanks to you. Must I do everything myself? I have practically won this war alone. Come now, turn things around. I knew I could have crushed them alone, but it would have been much easier if you had helped out more. The enemy is crushed thanks to us. Well, mostly thanks to you. Now we have them. Keep up the pressure. I am proud to have you as the stronger ally. Together, we are taking the war to the enemy. At least I am able to help. Ha! I was too strong for you, so you had to call for your big brother to come help. Coward. What is this? You need help to fight me? Cannot do it alone, can you? Chicken. Ha! Now together we will crush your puny force. You cannot stand against us both. No human could. Now this is the kind of battle I like. Vast numbers of soldiers, with a variety of commanders, all pushed together into the scrim. Have at you! I see you have banded together in hopes of forestalling your doom. It will not help you. You see, our armies have teamed up as well. My armies crushed, my town a burning ruin. It is hopeless. I must offer my surrender. Only 1 minute. Inconceivable! Attack! 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 For we are at the critical moment. Ha! We have them now. 1 minute left before our enemy's total humiliation. Just one short minute and the game ends. Our foe is doomed and is all because of my... our power. I have not lost yet. Ah, I still have time to snatch victory from your unworthy hands. Coward, come face me on battlefield. It is all over but the victory parade now. I tire of you. Now we will be finished. The end is near, cur. Grovel before me, and I might show mercy. Who am I kidding? Those knaves! Let us seek immediate retribution upon their bodies. They will pay for their insolence. Too bad. Now I will have to crush you the old-fashioned way. Ha! I knew you would not be able to pull it off. Now, real fight begins. I have crushed your monopoly, and now you are mine. Any last wishes before my army destroys your pathetic colony? Curse their eyes! The enemy has monopoly. They cannot win with strength, so they are trying with cunning. Quickly, we must destroy one of the enemy posts, or all is lost. The cowards! They are not worthy of sniffing my boots. Building trading posts is not the most glorious way to win war, but is certainly effective. They have to come to us now to keep us from winning. Let us prepare an ambush. Good, I tire of these curs. Let us be done with them by any means possible. You would settle for winning that way? I am almost ashamed to be fighting you. Ha! You cannot believe your trading post will survive the Russian army. So, you do not think you can beat me on battlefield? You are right, coward. Ha! The final nails in your coffin are being hammered right now. If, and is big if, you have trustworthy heirs, now would be the time to send them away. The shadow of mighty Russian Empire has fallen on your pathetic colony. The Aztecs are ground to dust beneath my boot heel. The Iroquois are ended. Who can stand before us? Not the Sioux. The Aztecs are a threat to our victory. We must attack. We should attack the Iroquois before they grow too strong. We have let the Sioux grow too strong. We must crush them before it's too late. The outlook is grim. The Aztecs cause even bold Cossacks to tremble in saddle. How did you let this happen? The Iroquois cannot be left to grow so strong. How can my soldiers face the strange tactics of the Sioux? Tell me. Ah, I see you do not know either. I can see the end coming for us. But the Aztecs are weak. Let us deal them one last blow. Though it's clear we will not win, my scouts report that the Iroquois are vulnerable. One good attack might do them in. Quickly, we are losing, but the Sioux are compromised. We can take them down with us.
Well, my little upstart, I can't buy our way out of this one. Well, my little upstart, stick with me and do as I do. Successes like these will become old hat. Splurge a little on some cannon and you'll see much better results on the battlefield. The power and speed of horses on the battlefield is an amazing thing. You should try using it. Many military conflicts are won by infantry might. If you build some more, you might witness this firsthand. Ah, my little upstart, you stand to lose more than you can handle. Ah, my little upstart, you stand to lose more than you will gain if you pursue that fight. If we win this conflict, our enemies will surely recognize our power. Did your scouts not warn you of the strength of my forces? Well, now you know to retreat when next we meet. My prowess on the battlefield is unmatched. It would be wise of you to respect it. Ah, my little upstart, throwing your troops into the mouth of a lion only feeds it and makes it stronger. As you can see, I did not become the leader of a strong nation without a strong military. My little upstart, soon you will learn true power is earned, not imagined. Another victory for our side. Soon this conflict will be over with. If you keep following my lead, your nation may become as strong as mine. With some money in their pockets and a will to survive, my soldiers can make miracles happen. I knew if I lost that battle, you would lose hope, my little upstart. So I turned the tide and won it for you. Victory out of defeat. Continue with your build-up, my little upstart. I have this situation well under control. My forces are well paid and well trained. This battle should be short and favor my side. I thought about retreating to your forces before this battle, but... Ah, my little upstart, I believe you may have turned this battle in our favor. This battle was mine to lose, and with the reinforcements the enemy is bringing, it looks like I shall. But of course, it shall be done. Right away. Very well. I shall use my wealth to purchase many large guns. The battlefield will be filled with my artillery and cavalry. The battlefield will be filled with my artillery and infantry. I know the abilities of cavalry well. I shall train many. Yes, cavalry backed by artillery. Two very expensive units, but I can certainly afford them both. Cavalry followed by foot soldiers. I will begin training my force now. I shall use all my resources to mass an army of foot soldiers. I will soon have an army of infantry, with some artillery mixed in for good measure. I will build a large infantry force and protect its flanks with smaller groups of cavalry. The wealth of my nation is being used in other ways for now. I regret to inform you that I cannot comply. I must respectfully decline. I cannot do as you ask for the time being. I know you are accustomed to seeing my great armies wielding their power on the field, but at this moment I have none. I am prohibited from doing such things. I do not have sufficient troops for that task. A minor setback. We will still be victorious in the end. The British are poor and weak. They should not be a threat for much longer. Rebels! Their challenge to my Dutch rule shall be over soon. I believe the French will be nothing but a memory soon. I would have never thought the Germans would resign so easily, but I think they will be forced to soon. The Ottomans are a worthy adversary, but I think their days are numbered. I sense the Portuguese will not last much longer. I fear these nearby trees more than I fear those Russians. The Spanish don't pose much of a threat anymore. They should resign soon. The British are a force to be reckoned with. I nominate you to do the reckoning. As usual, the Dutch are wealthy and near unbeatable. We should make for the French, or they might just ride right over us. The German army is a well-oiled machine. It would be wise to fear them. As it stands right now, the Ottomans may overpower us. I do not want to believe it, but the Portuguese are a worthy opponent here in the New World. It seems the Russian forces are as fierce as their winters. The Spanish power may be unmatched in the New World. We will need to work together to defeat them. It seems your wealth and knowledge have surpassed mine. Would you mind sharing some of your good fortune? Ah, my little upstart. I hope you haven't rushed up the age too soon. It will be some time before my technology matches yours. I don't know how you advanced so soon, but I hope you're full of surprises as good as this one. The enemy has formed an alliance with the natives here. They will help to defeat our forces. A powerful nation has both a strong economy and military, but you need to advance an age to even begin your military production. I hope someday soon your nation will match mine in age advancement. Why are you still in that age? Do you need resources? Advance the age soon. I don't want barbarians for allies. Your quick age advancement should strike some fear into our adversaries. Being the first to advance an age can be very powerful if you use your new researches and units wisely. Wow, that was fast. Maybe I should just pay you to fight all my battles for me. If you wish to lead a powerful nation, you need to keep up with the rest of us, my little upstart. Technology is the way of the future, my little upstart. Try not to stay in the past so long next time. Being last to age 2 doesn't prove you're the weakest, but it doesn't disprove it either. I owe you a debt of gratitude for rescuing my explorer. Thank you for rescuing my explorer. I just can't seem to keep him out of trouble. My rescued explorer, myself, my nation, and his family send you many thanks for your efforts. I have crushed the bond between our enemy and his former native allies while thwarting attempt at an easy victory. The natives will no longer do the bidding of their evil ally. I have driven quite a wedge between our enemy and his native ally. My little upstart, sometimes you have to take your enemies apart piece by piece, or in this case, town by town. This town is no more. We should plan our next move. They will get no more value from this trade post. The enemy barely survived my attacks, but in the end, their native trade post is still standing. That tyrant is more powerful than I thought. And yes, the enemy town still stands. I thought I could destroy our enemy's trade post, but their strength was greater than I had anticipated. I'm not sure, but I think I've lost my explorer. Oh, wait. No, he's dead again. My explorer has been killed again. I promise if you rescue him, he will be more careful in the future. Hey, my little upstart, when my explorer is up again, could you leave a circle of your troops around him from now on? I'm sure he'll live longer that way. I hope the enemy doesn't find my explorer's body, or he might think I'm weak for losing units before I even face him. My explorer has died, but not by the hand of my enemy. Well, my little upstart, I blame your lack of tactics for my defeat. I'm ready to resign at any moment. Maybe I can pay off our enemies so they will grant us safe passage home after I offer my surrender. I can't deal with this matter on my own. Please send help. Things are getting out of hand in this area. Could you come take care of it, my little upstart? This is getting out of control. I need your troops in my town now. The enemy forces in my town are much larger than what I have to defend with. You might consider sending reinforcements. In my town, there are just too many. I look forward to many successes with you as my ally. It pleases me to see you are my ally. We should make short work of our enemies. Hello, my little upstart. Stick by me and you'll become more powerful than you can imagine. So, you believe your skills have improved since last we met. Let's see how you fare this time, and then I'll be the judge. I'll tone things down a bit and try to be a little less competitive. I'm still reeling from when last we met, but I'm sure I'll fare much better this time with you as my ally. You may have outscored me the last time we met, but I will be the dominant player in this match. Ah, my little upstart. Finally came to your senses and joined my side, eh? The last time we met, your score was pretty low. I hope you've improved since then. I see you prefer the playstyle this map offers, which is good, since I do as well. Heed my advice this time, my little upstart, and we should fare much better. Let us make sure our fate in this match is the same as the last one. Well, I paid the ransom for my explorer. Let's hope he stays alive a little longer this time around. My explorer must be a spy. He keeps dying in enemy territory, forcing me to pay the enemy a hefty ransom to get him back each time. This explorer just makes me poor, and my enemies richer with each ransom. Ha! I was able to rescue my explorer without paying his ransom. I've rescued my explorer. Let's see how long he lives. Well, it seems our enemy is too poor to maintain an army to defend his town. We should take advantage and strike. My scouts tell me the enemy has no barracks in this town. Cavalry should ride through it unimpeded. Bring the big guns. Our artillery should be safe attacking the enemy's town since he has no stable. A wealthy nation is a strong nation, so here's some coin. I assume you will use this food wisely. I have all the wood I need right now. I'm sending some of my extra logs. The enemy base here makes some of my settlers nervous, so I'm going to destroy it. My forces are on the move to the enemy base. I shall be declaring a glorious victory in the near future. The enemy settlers are making him rich. I plan to send a small force to take some out. You have to hit the heart to kill the beast. I march on the enemy's main town. Watch me take the enemy's main town, my little upstart. You might learn something. The alliance to these natives is a boost to the enemy's forces I can no longer allow him to have. This trade post might make the enemy wealthier than me. I must destroy it. I see you're in a fight. My troops are on the way. Looks like you're doing well over there. But I'm sending my forces in to make sure it stays that way. Rest easy, my little upstart. My forces are en route to make sure the outcome there is in our favor. This will be the location of my next military base. My new town will be built in this location. I shall form an alliance with these natives to bolster our forces. I believe these natives will be very helpful in the future. We Dutch are amazing traders. It only makes sense I build a trade post. Once I finish this trade post, my wealth will grow immensely. This building shall not fall. This area has too much value. I will not let the enemy take it. I cannot allow the enemy to break our alliance with those natives. My forces will protect that area. My forces will protect this town. I will not let the enemy take this trade post. Feel good, knowing that Dutch coin will continue to flow into your coffers. Your people should never go hungry with this food I'm sending you. I suspect I'll see a whole new colony soon from the wood I'm sending you.
Hold on. My troops are on the way.
I see you are having trouble defending yourself, my little upstart. Don't worry. My forces are en route.
I'm ready to send troops there to help turn back the enemy.
It's been quiet. Maybe too quiet.
Hope all is well over there. All is fine here.
Did you know my father was called the Silent?
Could you spare some coin? Just this once, I promise.
My people are hungry. Do you have some food to spare?
I need to build a bank or something.
Could I have some wood?
I knew the enemy was lost once your forces showed up. Our combined forces on the battlefield. Is there a better duo?
Thank you, my little upstart. Your troops, although not needed, were welcomed for joining my forces in that battle. I shall put this coin to good use. Your generosity is greatly appreciated. My base survives because of you. Thank you. The goods you sent me will not go to waste. This wood will build many great structures in my town. Our outcome looks bleak when looking at the strength of the British player. If anyone could put us between a rock and a hard place, I should have known it would be the Dutch. The French ride all over us. As yet, we cannot stop them. The Ottomans are mighty. They will surely be the cause of our demise. When did the Portuguese become so tough? Seems the Russians are as many and as strong here in the New World as they are back home. The Spanish are everywhere. I do not know if we can defeat them. All is not lost. The British are barely holding on. The situation is not in our favor, but the Dutch are conformable. We need to turn the tide of this contest. I sense the French are no real threat to us. It seems the Germans are lost and sputtering out of control. Through them, we might be able to change our future. The enemy seems too strong, but I think the Portuguese are their weak link. We may be behind right now, but the Russians shouldn't last much longer.
We are not doing so well, but the Spanish are doing even worse. Please forgive me. I fear I will be the cause of our great alliance not prospering as it should.
You are the pinnacle of our strength, my little upstart. But I'm not sure you'll be enough to get us out of this one.
Looks like the end is near. I do not think my strength is enough to hold for the both of us.
I will have to train you to be more my equal so that we may crush our enemies instead of them crushing us. Our combined strength is unmatched.
It seems you're keeping up with me quite well, my little upstart. The enemy no longer has the strength to stand up to our power. This alliance has brought me great prosperity. You're better than I imagined you could be. Looks like I will ride to glory again.
On your coattails, of course.
It's okay your nation isn't as strong as mine. I'll take us both to victory.
Don't worry, my little upstart. I'm doing well enough for the both of us.
This battle is lost. If we resign now, perhaps we can fight together another day.
We fought the good fight, but we've been beaten. All is lost. Let us resign and take them on again.
We've missed our chance at victory. Let us resign and fight again.
They have forged the first alliance with the natives here, but it will be their last. The enemy is looking to increase their wealth by building on a trade site. They are forging more native alliances. We might see more native warrior on the field than we can handle.
They've built another trade post. They must be stopped.
Good move. Your natives will surely help crush our enemies.
I'm sure the enemy is quite jealous of your new trade post.
Nice work. That treasure should be helpful. Resources and units from treasures are always a nice bonus.
Extra coin to your coffers. Spend it wisely.
You should use that food to build more settlers and expand your economy. You must be a skillful leader to take such advantage of the treasures around you.
As long as you put that treasure to good use, I won't mind you taking it from my lands.
Native warriors, a welcome addition to any army.
Extra settlers should really help to get your economy going. Extra wood is never a bad thing to have.
Having the upper hand with the natives in this region definitely favors our side.
Having more trade sites helps create a wealthier nation. And I believe a wealthy nation is a strong nation.
Wall defenses should hold the enemy back for a time.
Are you getting scared, my little upstart?
Don't fret. My forces will protect you as well.
It seems our enemy underestimates the power of these natives, but I do not. Like a good businessman, a leader must look for ways to improve his wealth, and that's what this trade post will do for me.
What's this? My explorer has done something useful.
I will use this treasure to strengthen both our nations. These treasures are very useful. Do you see some more? The rich just keep getting richer. This extra food will help feed my nation. I have been eyeing this treasure for some time now, since you didn't take it.
I did.
You should try to find some more treasures. They're really a boost to any nation.
If you wish to be powerful and wealthy like me, you need to find more treasures, my little upstart. I shall use this native warrior to scout and destroy our enemies. Maybe I'll use this wood for a market or bank. I couldn't let those tyrants have more native alliances in this region than us. More trade sites means more wealth, and you know, I like being wealthy. The enemy forces are making me nervous, so I'm putting up some walls so they cannot surprise me. For the kind! Let's research the victory condition and put an end to this war. Are you an imposter? Because your skill rating was much higher the last time we played. I see you've been practicing, my little upstart. Your skill rating is much higher than I last remember it. I see you've gained quite a bit of experience since we played last. I hope your home city is more powerful to show for it. You might defeat me this time, but no, it won't be easy to do again. Only 1 minute until the end. Can you feel the pressure? What a glorious fight! Many heroes will be born today. You should turn and run. This battle does not look good for you. Are those the only troops your nation could afford? I'm telling you this as an enemy that respects you. You should retreat. My ally has come to save me. Don't you wish you ran while you had the chance? I see you could not face me alone, obviously begging your ally for assistance. Your technological advances will not save you from the wrath of my forces. How did you manage to age up so quickly? You must tell me your secret. Those natives will not be enough to stop my forces. You have saved yourself the wrath of many native warriors by destroying that trade post. My town center is lost, but I am not. Drat! That trade post was bringing me much wealth. Please, advance the age. I don't want to destroy another nation of barbarians. Are you aware of my technological advances? Perhaps you should try to catch up. Rushing up age will not guarantee you victory in the end. A little slow on your age advancement, I see. Perhaps you need a minute before I attack. Your town center is far from your ally. After I destroy this one, I'm sure you'll build your next one a lot closer to him. Building next to your ally is the best decision you've made all game, my little upstart. Did you think I would allow you to win in such a manner? Your native alliance was making you too powerful, so I ended it for you. Your town center is lost. You will be as well if you do not make the smart decision and resign now. I know the wealth a trade post can provide. Therefore, I could not allow you to keep yours much longer. A fine day for a war, is it not? If you consider resigning now, I might give you 200 gold for your troubles. No formal hellos now. I'll make your acquaintance later, on the battlefield. I respect you challenging yourself by raising the skill level, but I fear the result may not be what you had hoped. Playing at a lower skill level this time, probably a smart choice when facing me. I think you feel this map type helps your play, but realize it also helps mine. It was wise of you to lessen the odds against you, but I do not think you lowered them enough. You could not stop me from rescuing my explorer, and I cannot stop him from destroying your town. My explorer is up, but don't worry, he's not much of a threat. I see your forces with an explorer keeping an eye for them. Well done. I just wanted you to know that force your explorer's leading round does not scare me. I'm warning you now, if those troops with your explorer come any closer to my town, I'm going to have to take him out. I see some of your units. They look lost. Where's your explorer? Those troops look like an easy target for my men to train their skill. For the safety of your own men, you should keep them in your town and away from my forces. It would be unwise of you to attack me with those forces near my base. Only the weak prey on defenseless settlers. You obviously need to attack settlers because my troops would cut yours to pieces. My losses will be dwarfed compared to what I'm about to do to you. Wow, that's an impressive force I see. Your force is of decent size, but I would advise not attacking with it. This will not bode well for me. Is that what you call a raid? I have found your town. Now I know where to strike. I've spotted your town, and for now it actually resembles mine in some ways. Well, my little upstart, if you want that town of yours to survive, you should surrender it to me now. It is unfortunate that you could not get this treasure, because it sure was helpful. Ha! My army is on your doorstep. I am here and prepared to fight. It is time to test your skills, my little upstart. My army is upon you. I so enjoy having time to build upon my economy. I hope you're using this time wisely. My next attack is not too far away. What do you do with your nation when I'm not attacking you? You have beaten me, and I would like to offer my surrender. I sense I can no longer obtain victory. May I resign now? Your actions have only delayed the inevitable.
Nicely done. Alliances with natives may be the path to victory in this conflict. That trade post will not help you gain more wealth than my banks can produce.
That is only one treasure. I will find many more than that.
Do you have the wisdom to use that treasure wisely? It is better you got that treasure, or I would have too great an advantage over you.
Seems your explorer finds useful things to do with his time,
unlike mine. Will you be able to buy an army to beat me with that little bit of coin?
A little bit of food? I'm not worried. You have an unfair advantage. Your explorer is doing something useful.
I left that treasure there as a trap. Now I'm going to hunt your explorer down.
Natives are good, but treasure will not be enough to help you in the end. I'm sure I could put those settlers to better use in my town. That will just give me more building to tear down. A wise plan to wall in, but they won't be enough to save you. I thought you were not afraid of me when we declared war on each other, but these walls make me think differently.
Be careful. Soon native warriors will be attacking your town.
This trade post will only add to my wealth. My explorer must really want to destroy you because he's actually helping to victory.
I'm sorry, but I could not allow you to have this treasure.
More coin to my coffers. This will help me field an army greater than yours.
Why do you leave such treasures for me on your lands?
I guess you know those lands will belong to me soon enough.
Is your explorer dead?
I haven't seen him.
You'll see him soon.
Attacking your town. Extra settlers for a wealthy nation. This cannot fare well for you.
This wood will help me build a barracks. Or a bank. Whichever.
That alliance won't last long. That trade site will help you become almost as wealthy as me. Trying to take the easy win condition, eh, my little upstart? I'll put an end to this nonsense.
Take the peaceful way, defeat, and just allow this timer to run out.
What happened to your rating?
Been facing more leaders like myself?
I see your rating is going up. Are you ready for your next lesson, my little upstart? I hope all that experience has made your home city more powerful than the last time we met.
One misfortune should not make one lose hope. If we cannot attack now, then it is indeed over. We have persevered this time, my friend. I told you that trust in me was well placed. Take it from an Ottoman. Artillery is what you need. Make falconets, cannon. Any kind of artillery will help you now. Cavalry will cut them down like lions among bunnies. Train cavalry, my friend. I do it all the time. It is very nice. Send in swordsmen or muskets. Anything on two legs. We Ottomans have won many battles with infantry. I suggest you try that strategy now. The mouse who has only one hole soon gets caught. You should retreat carefully, my ally. No matter how far you have gone down a wrong road, turn back. Retreat and live, my friend. The battle you enter will be bloody. I advise caution, my ally. Even retreat. Be careful. The enemy seems an ant, but I see him an elephant. Rethink your fight, my friend. We can discuss plans over cups of frothing Aran. When enemies gather like bees to honey, victory will be sweet. They are afraid of us. See how they rally together. I prefer a nice warm bath after winning such an easy battle. One does not burn a blanket to get rid of a flea like our enemy. We will drink thick boza to toast my victory. You do like chickpeas, yes? Another victory for the armies of the Ottoman Empire. If a man is judged by his work, I will be a hero when I return home. Luck has found me today. A hard-won victory for our noble alliance. My soldiers fight like lions. My armies will be wolves among sheep. Perhaps after this battle you will join me for a meal. This battle will be good practice for my men. I will leave this battle to one of my viziers. Our enemy is a green twig, easily bent and broken. This battle will be short. A heavy stone is not easily moved. Thank you for your aid. Reinforcements have turned the tide. Just as drop by drop, water will make a pond. Our enemies gather like buzzing flies. Another army joins the battle. They multiply like rabbits. I agree. The candle does not give light to itself. I will. I honor your request. To this, I agree. I am Ottoman. Artillery is my specialty. More cannon for my good friend. Artillery, you say? It will be my pleasure. I will train cannon and guard them with hussars. I will send janissaries and cannon. You will hear the charge of 1,000 horses. I agree with that assessment. We will train cavalry to use against the enemy. Ottomans have strong hussars. We will be glad to bring them to battle. I will train hussars and support them with cannon. I will train a mixed army, some horse and some foot. We will sharpen our scimitars and polish our muskets and prepare a glorious army of infantry. Janissaries it is, then. My janissaries will enjoy marching into battle. Janissaries and artillery. The perfect Ottoman army. We will train janissaries and support them with cavalry units. Alas, my coffers are empty. All that I have would be yours, my friend, if indeed I had anything. Although I must suffer in great agony for denying such a noble request, I still must do so. I am not worthy to be your ally, for I cannot afford your request. I hope someday your children's children can forgive me. That would be possible, yet I seem to have spent what little I had. You can ask 1,000 times, and the answer will still be no. Such a thing is impossible. Although you deserve much more, such a thing is not to be. I would grant you the keys to the gates of paradise if I could, but for now, I can do nothing. I know it is your expectation, the Ottoman army, to be mighty and endless, but sometimes our reputation precedes us, and we have not the troops just yet. I could send you our finest cooks, tailors, and animal handlers, but as for soldiers, we have none. We are a long way from the Ottoman Empire, my friend, and I have not the troops to spare. If such a thing were possible. But it is not. A force greater than both of us prevents that. It has been decreed that such a thing is not to be. We are but a poor colony with few soldiers. I have a janissary or two, but not enough to be of assistance. My troops are dining at the moment. I cannot spare them. We were so close to victory, my friend. Perhaps we should try again. They destroyed one of our trading posts and stole our well-deserved victory away. The British are very weak. The Dutch will resign soon. The French will surrender. They often do. I have fought Germans many times, so I know they will soon resign. There is only room for one Ottoman colony, and it will be mine. We will drive them back to Portugal. These Russians will not be a threat much longer. Remember back when the Spanish were actually dangerous? The British army is quite strong. I do not know how they do it, but the Dutch are a big threat. France often has a huge army, and I fear this time is no exception. I have fought Germans many times. They can be quite dangerous. It appears I have a rival for the control of the Ottoman Empire. Keep your eye on the Portuguese. They are our biggest threat. Russians like to attack early. Be prepared. These Spanish often have strong infantry and cavalry. You advance quickly. That is good. But do not overextend yourself. I have seen birds that do not fly as fast as you. I hope you did not advance too early. You must have resources coming in quickly to be able to go up before me. Let us use that to our advantage. Our enemy is forging alliances with the local people. Did you see that? Our enemy has allied with another Native American. Our enemy appears to be going for a Native American strategy. Let our enemy forge alliances. It will come to naught in the end. You need to advance in age if you are to have a military. Is this some secret strategy, my friend? Or have hard times fallen upon you? Staying in an early age for so long can be dangerous. Are you behind, my friend? How can I help? Have faith, my ally. Though you are behind, it is not too late to advance to the next age. He who asks advice passes the mountain. He who does not loses his way on the level plain. Do you need aid? We are allies. It is no shame to ask for help. Do you need coin or food to advance in age? I will share if I can. You have beaten our enemy to the second age. If skills could be learned by watching, every dog would be a butcher, and we would all advance in age with you. Activity breeds prosperity. One day, share with me the secret of your speed. Our enemies will eat the dust kicked up by your progress. With patience, mulberry leaves become satin. I am sure you are weaving very fine cloth. A horse ridden slowly reaches its destination, my friend. The enemy rushes forward blindly in haste. You are patient and wise. Silks made slowly wear longest. We harvest what we sow. You have sown patience. We will harvest victory. My explorer is rescued. You have the gratitude of the Ottoman Empire. My explorer is on his feet. I will send word of your deeds to his family. You have rescued my explorer and saved me coin. I am truly grateful. My explorer, you saved him. I hope that he may be of service to you soon. The family of my explorer sends their gratitude for his rescue. My faithful explorer is rescued. Hopefully he will be more cautious in the future. I have saved us from the lion's jaws. I have stopped the timer. We must take advantage of this opportunity. Our enemies will barter with these natives no more. These natives may wish to barter with us now. Our enemies' alliance with these natives is broken. These natives may wish to ally with the Ottomans now. Again, I have conquered our enemy. I have brought falling embers to our enemy's colony. Our enemy's colony sheds embers into the darkening sky. The cries and smoke are thick in our enemy's colony. White clothes become dirty. Our enemy's colony is no more. Our enemy will not grow fat from this trading post. The enemy controls this trading post no longer. This trading post is dead to me. I have destroyed an enemy trading post. Our enemy's trading post is burnt to the ground. The enemy's alliance with this tribe is sound. I will have to try again. Our enemy's alliance with this tribe is as thick as marble. I did not expect their buildings to be so well constructed. The enemy colony still stands. For now. I underestimated their preparedness. It will not happen again, my ally. My most sincere apologies, ally. I did not destroy the trading post. You must excuse me, my ally. My explorer has fallen, and I must prepare his family for the news. This new world is full of evil beasts with sharp teeth, some of which have claimed my explorer. There is little to gain from further conflict. I am fighting our enemy here. Rally your soldiers to the banner of Suleiman the Magnificent. My colony is overrun. The enemy swarms my colony like fleas on a camel. I am besieged. At mealtime, our enemy is less than a dog. I am Suleiman the Magnificent. Perhaps you have heard of me. I am Suleiman the Magnificent. I toast the beginning of our alliance with warm boza. I am Suleiman the Magnificent. I am the Ottoman Empire. Our engagements grow more and more challenging. I trust you are ready. You are wise to choose your battles carefully. A stair is climbed step by step. He who was once my enemy is now my friend. Greetings again. Perhaps this time I will keep up with you. So I defeated you before, and now you come to me as an ally. So be it. I shall not turn you away. I hope that you learned from me during our last encounter. Be strong this time. One crow does not make winter. You like to fight on this map. Yes, this time we shall win. Patience is the key to paradise. So, shall we drive them before us once more? Once a friend, always a friend. We will be victorious again. My explorer is restored to me. His family has sent ransom in cattle and silks. Good. My explorer can now resume humble service to Suleiman the Magnificent. Our mutual enemy's town appears defenseless. It seems our enemy's colony is undefended. Our enemy appears to have no infantry. Perhaps we should strike. I have seen the enemy town and did not see a barracks. We should not expect an army of infantry. My scouts report that our enemy is not training cavalry. Ottoman scouts report that there is no stable in our enemy's colony. Ottomans always have coin to spare. I will share my wealth. The generosity of the Ottoman Empire is legendary. Have some coin. I was going to commission a new saddle for my horse, but perhaps this coin is better spent on you instead. You can never say that Suleiman never gave you anything. He who has no bread has no authority. A person cannot fight on an empty stomach. Janissaries are famous for their cooking. Perhaps you'd like a taste. Olives from the Mediterranean, dates from Mesopotamia. All for you to sample. Janissaries never march to war without their soup pots. Perhaps you'd like to share. This lumber came all the way from Asia. Wood. Wood for buildings, for ships, and for artillery. Here, my friend, use this wood for the glory of both our nations. To celebrate our alliance, I have sent you a gift of fine lumber. I was going to cast this away, seeing how flush with resources my colonies are, but perhaps you can make use of this wood. Prepare to witness my magnificent attack upon our unsuspecting enemy. Like a wind across the desert, my forces ride towards the enemy colony. We will fall upon the enemy colony like lions at the feast. Study this colony well. In a moment, there will be nothing left. Now you will see the full might of the Ottoman Empire as we raise this town. Now you will watch as the little people flee before me. If you see smoke on the horizon, it is my army in our enemy's town. My soldiers rally under the crescent banner. We march! Our enemy has forged an alliance with the natives here. It will not last. He who has no bread has no authority. I go to take the bread from our enemy. My soldiers march to join yours, my ally. Guests bring good luck. I will join you in your attack. A wise man remembers his friends at all times. I am sending soldiers with you. I am building a new camp to train soldiers. The Ottomans claim this territory for our next colony. Soon this land too will experience the bounty of the Ottoman Empire. Suleiman the Magnificent claims this land for a new colony. I am going to convince these Native Americans to form an alliance. 1,000 friends are too few. I will try to ally with the Native Americans here. We need more trade. I will start with this site. Coffee and silk will bring great wealth in these lands. I will build a trading post. This building shall not fall. I will not let this building fall while my soldiers have breath. I will make my stand here. I will hold this ground until star and moon fall. I will defend our alliance with the Native Americans. I am sending soldiers to protect our alliance with the Native Americans. My soldiers will defend this town through 1,000 winters. This town will not fall to our enemy. I will defend the trade route. One who handles honey licks his fingers. Gold does not rust on the ground, but this trade post will not defend itself. I will share the wealth of my empire by sending you coin. When my coffers overflow, I will send extra coin to you. My silos are full. I can send you food. A red apple invites stones, but I will continue to share my food with you. If you can still use wood, I will continue to send it. Our buildings are of stone and plaster. I will send you wood that we do not use. I am on my way. Hold as long as you can. My soldiers rally to your flag. The armies of Suleiman the Magnificent will arrive soon. My people say, if you have never been sunburned, you will never know a shadow's value. My people say, listen 100 times, ponder 1,000 times, speak once. My people say, 2 watermelons cannot be held under 1 arm. My people say, coffee should be strong as death, sweet as love, and black as hell. My people say, the plumber's house always leaks. My people say, you will reach for a snake if you fall into the sea. My people say, do not search for a calf under the ox. A wise man remembers his friends at all times. A fool, only when he has need of them. Patience is bitter, but it bears sweet fruit. My people say, no one gives alms to a closed palm. Do you need anything? If you trust me as an ally, you will send me coin. Can you spare coin? It will be a good investment. Do you have food you can spare? An open mouth remains not hungry. I need food, my ally. Send me wood, my friend. My colony grows. Can you spare some wood? The sight of your army makes me smile, friend. I shall treat your army to a feast when we are done. Your soldiers are a welcome sight. I can use that coin. My thanks. We shall put this food to good use. My thanks for your assistance. It takes two hands to make a sound. I, Suleiman the Magnificent, thank you. The Ottoman Empire thanks you. I will spend any resources you can send to me. Ah, more wood. Excellent. The British are cunning, and their armies are well equipped. It does not look good for us. The Dutch know more of warfare than I expected. The outlook is grim. The French are as dangerous as I feared. We fight a losing fight. The Germans are a relentless enemy. We are losing ground. It is not surprising that one of my countrymen is a match for both of us. The Portuguese are endlessly resourceful. This is a dark day. Is there nothing we can do to turn the Russian tide? The Spanish stand poised to crush us. We only have to wait. My children's grandchildren will be shamed by losing to the British. Despite their inferior troops, the Dutch continue to defeat us. It is humiliating that we are losing to the French. If we lose to the Germans, I will never be considered fit to lead in battle again. I cannot stand to lose to this traitorous Ottoman commander. I cannot believe you allowed the Portuguese to beat us. The Russians swarm like ants, and we let them. I do not know how I allowed the Spanish to beat us. We sprinkled blood on a dying tree. Blood I can spare no longer. My armies have fought like lions to protect our colonies, but it is not enough. A white day sheds light. A black day sheds darkness. This is a white day. You do well, my ally. A lion sleeps in the heart of every brave man. Though I am the stronger, I know you will still contribute to this alliance. We fought valiantly, but the time has come to resign. A white day sheds light, a black day sheds darkness. This is a black day. Every sheep is hung by his own leg. I fear we head toward slaughter. We cannot win this. Empty words will not fill an empty stomach. Even the highest tree has an axe waiting at its foot. We are finished. Either drive this camel to pasture or leave the country. We are done here. It is easier to teach a camel to jump than to convince you to resign. We should have known they would try to win this way. Our enemy has established an alliance with some of the Native Americans here. We should pursue our own alliances. Our enemy is swift, or we are slow. We should build our own trading posts, or destroy his. The Native Americans have found a strong ally in you. And in another thing, you are the first. It is wise to establish trade while others only consider it. Your explorer has keen eyes. Excellent. Your discovery will speed our victory. I'm sure that will fetch a fine price at the bazaar, my friend. It is a fine explorer that feeds his people. But beware the chokecherries. My explorer is more diplomat than outdoorsman. I would be honored if your explorer tutored him. Take it. My people say, let your neighbor be well off, for then he will not ask you for anything. A Native American warrior will be a great aid to you. Your compassion for the helpless will return to us in time. Your explorer has a good eye for the exotic woods found here. Your alliances with the native people will serve us well. Eat and drink with your friends, but do not trade with them. Present company excluded, of course. I have this advice for your walls. Measure 1,000 times. Cut once. Remember, small keys unlock big doors. And cannon. Cannon work also. My emissaries have secured the first alliance with the Native Americans. This land is in need of dates and silks. I will sell Ottoman luxuries in the wilderness. This land is vast and full of wonders. This new world could prove lucrative after all. Exotic food for my new colony. Did I warn you about choke cherries? My apologies. This explorer is young and eager. He will not gather treasures on your doorstep again. My explorer is swift and keen-eyed, but I'm sure there are still treasures for you to claim. A Native American warrior. He will be a great help to my efforts. There is much to learn, but each settler builds a piece of the Ottoman Empire. There is little wood in our architecture. Still, this wood is useful. The sincerity of my words draws more allies to our alliance. Our enemy has glutted the markets with baubles and trash. Now all will see superior Ottoman goods. I am building a wall around my colony. An open door is an invitation to the viper. A red apple invites stones. Our prosperity will make us a target. We must prepare. Sorrow is to the soul what the worm is to wood. Do not let your losses eat at you. Stairs are climbed step by step, though you appear to have leapt them two by two. You have seen many battles since we last met. Let us win this one together. There is still time for me to pull victory from the lion's mouth. We persevered, and so we shall be rewarded. It is the aunt or uncle of all battles. No matter how tall a tree grows, its leaves always fall to the ground. A dog that intends to bite does not bare its teeth. I will remember this for next time. It is more difficult to contend with oneself than the world. This defeat is my own. You are a worthy enemy. I will stop underestimating you. You turn my attacks as the moon turns the tide. I must rethink my strategy. I have learned from this battle. Do not expect that you will win another. You have won a great victory, but as rain does not soak marble, you will not defeat me. Ah! I would have won that engagement, but you made me spill coffee on my robes. You lose. A donkey is a donkey even when he is finely saddled. Try not to get too much blood on my robes. They are oriental silk. Very expensive. If anyone weeps for you, it will be your mother. Others will only pretend to weep. A man becomes experienced by being defeated. A scholar by making mistakes. I think you must be very learned. Beauty passes, wisdom remains. You must be very wise to have stolen victory from me. He who would gather honey must bear the sting of bees. Your soldiers are in disarray. Their leader sounds an uncertain trumpet. Sorrow is to the soul what the worm is to wood. The battle is turning. The cock that crows too early gets his head cut off. Only your ally saved you this time. Next time, you will not be so fortunate. You age up quickly, but every man has his own way of eating yogurt. What flares up fast extinguishes soon. Your native allies will make no difference in the end. If you have something to say to me, say it in my town and leave my allies out of this. You will pay for what you have done. Relish your victory. But know that the liar's candle will only last until evening. Yet once again, we see that beauty passes. Wisdom remains. You grow lethargic in the first age. For the lean ox, there is no knife. Are you still competing, or have you gone off to compose music? To the snake that does not bite me, may he live 1,000 years. Do not roll up your trousers before reaching the stream. The fly in a hurry falls into the milk. Oh, I forgot about you. Are you still in this fight? Two camels fight, and the fly in between dies. You will be crushed. You are miles away from your ally. You have no hope. You are alone. A sheep separated from the flock. You huddle together like baby chickens. That is quite enough of that. This too shall be mine. Suleiman the Magnificent pronounces this colony unfit. Resign now, and you may leave in peace. This building offended me, so I have destroyed it. Watch your tongue when you speak to me. Sharp vinegar only damages its container. You will harvest what you sow. The fly is small, but it can upset your stomach. There is no rose without a thorn, nor contest without a rival. A weapon is an enemy, even to its owner. 1,000 friends are too few. 1 enemy is too many. You will learn the truth of this soon. I see you enjoy a challenge. Then I shall give you one. Yes, I was too much for you last battle. I will go easier on you this time. Very well. We shall try again. You bit off more bread than you could swallow last time. Perhaps this time will go better for you. You leap into a sea full of sharks. A daring rescue that will be the subject of 100 poems. I have looked into the eyes of my enemy, and I do not like what I see there. I see your soldiers. Do not think they are hiding. Is this a raid? Are you sure you are ready? I will not go easy on you. The hare was angry at the mountain, but the mountain was unaware of it. Your army is meaningless. You prey on those who cannot defend themselves. There is no honor in that. An army that size, I suspect they do not bring tidings of your imminent surrender. In case your runners have been lost, your army has strayed into my territory. I would advise you to withdraw. Suleiman the Magnificent will not forget how you attacked this colony.
Ah,
a scouting party. A wise man speaks of what he sees. There is no need for a guide to a village which is visible. I see your colony there. I told my cartographers not to bother adding it to their map. A bird steals bread from beneath the nose of the unwary. Better to die on an empty stomach than live on an empty one. You have eaten, yes? A single misfortune is better than 1,000 warnings. A good man will appear when talked about. You must have said my name. He who steals a minaret prepares a case for it. When you are an anvil, be patient. When you are a hammer, be strong. A carefree head is only found on a scarecrow. I admit defeat. Will you accept my surrender? I have struggled against you long enough. Shall we call this finished? Enough! You have won. I will resign if you will permit me. Thorns and roses grow on the same tree. The rose you have found will soon show you its thorns. Do not think Suleiman is blind to the tendrils you spread across the new world. Your explorer is eager. He better watch out for bears and janissaries. I am sure news of your discovery will make all the effort worthwhile. I think I heard the clinking of coin into your coffers. Spend it wisely. Be careful of the food in this new world, especially the choke cherries. Send my compliments to your explorer for his collection of unusual vermin and weeds. Stay away from my town. The sheep separated from the flock gets eaten by the wolf. Native Americans know these lands well. I curse that I did not find him before you did. You will have need of every settler you have when I begin my attacks. You should use that wood to build a boat and sail home. Or perhaps I can loan you a swift Ottoman galley. Build defenses if you must, but an overprotected eye always gets the speck. Do you forget I am Ottoman? I will bring artillery to knock down your silly walls. My skillful diplomats have forged alliance with the natives here while you ignore them. The wealth of the Ottoman Empire is built on trade. Why should the New World be different? This too is mine. All the New World is Suleiman's to explore. If you could only see how much wealth we have amassed. More food for my soldiers. I fly in like a hawk to grasp a treasure right under your nose. You seem to be having trouble finding treasures. Would it help if I pointed them all out to you? The Ottomans accept people of all cultures into our glorious empire. More population for the Ottoman Empire. I will use this wood to make more buildings for the Ottoman Empire. It will not be long before the Native Americans see your true treachery. No one will want the worthless trinkets you peddle at your trade post. My armies will crush the victory you seek. But where will they strike? There are now many places you must defend. But where will Suleiman attack? My victory is inevitable. Surrender, and I will treat you and your soldiers to a feast in my colony. The moment of my victory approaches, I can hear the bombard sounding. I see you have learned that every downhill has an uphill, and every uphill a downhill. I hear your name in the whispers of conquered foes. I would watch your back. You have fought more battles since last we met. My tent is lined with banners of experienced leaders like you.
If we cannot attack their trading posts now, then it is indeed over.
I told you that trust in me was well placed. We are close to victory. We have persevered this time, my friend. There is still time for me to snatch victory from the lion's mouth. No matter where you go, your destiny follows you. Yours has followed you to the brink of defeat. He bites his tongue who speaks in haste. Do not crow your victory from the hilltops yet.
I have persevered, and soon I shall be rewarded.
If skill could be gained by watching, then dogs would be butchers, and you would be a general. One already wet does not feel the rain. You, my friend, are soaked in failure.
They have destroyed one of our trading posts and stolen away our well-deserved victory. We were so close to victory, my friend. Perhaps we should try again. Thorns and roses grow from the same root. The rose you have found will soon show you its thorns.
That is quite enough of that.
An open door invites enemies. Forgive me for walking through yours and crushing you. Your children's grandchildren will not look back on this defeat with shame. No, not at all. We should have known they would try to win this way. Victory does not come so easily as starting a timer. Who buys cheap, buys dear. They have chosen to be the nail rather than the hammer. Poor choice. A red apple invites stones. Our prosperity will make us a target. We must prepare. We have chosen to be the anvil rather than the hammer. Our patience will outlast your strength. Patience is bitter, but it bears sweet fruit. Now the waiting begins. My armies will crush the victory you seek. But where will they strike? There are many places you must defend, but where will Suleiman attack?
You cannot hold two watermelons under one arm. How do you expect to keep all those trading posts?
My victory is inevitable. Surrender, and I will treat you and your soldiers to a feast in my colony. The moment of my victory approaches, I can hear the bombard sounding. I am sure your children's children will be able to forgive your coming defeat. The Aztecs rival the Ottoman Empire in grandeur, though not for much longer. The Iroquois alliances are shattered, and their time at an end. Fierce though they were, the Sioux are nearly finished. I can see smoke rising from the Aztec temples, but I do not believe the cities are burning. This makes me uneasy. The Iroquois are like lions. We had best keep a close eye on them. I hear hoofbeats in the distance. The Sioux are not idle. We must be wary. The Aztecs drain our strength like spilled blood. The Iroquois have proven stronger than our alliance. My ally, our mistakes catch up with us like the swift hoofbeats of Sioux warriors. We can discuss our many missteps later, with wine over a proper meal. But now, before we lose, let us attack the Aztecs one last time. We are in poor shape, but so are the Iroquois. Come, my ally, let us march on them one last time. The Sioux are weak, but we should be able to defeat them. There is no shame in small victories.
What? How can this be? I cannot fight on without troops or resources. I tender my resignation to you. I'm sure I'd be able to conquer you if we only fought a little longer. But in the interest of saving time, I hereby offer to quit in your favor. Is that acceptable? I shall start an offensive at this point. The French need this area, so we shall take it. When I capture this base, it will unravel the enemy's position. We should combine our forces to destroy him at this point. I am sending my armies now. The French tricolor will stand at this point before we are done. Attack L'Outrance! By my calculations, the time is ripe to destroy the main enemy town here. The enemy will no longer benefit from this native alliance. I am going to destroy their base here. The enemy's control of these natives has been a pain like a boil. I am about to lance it. I am going to deny the enemy this trading site. No more trade for the enemy here. This is the most strategic place for me to set up a new base. The enemy will not like the base I'm going to construct here. Here is my next town center. Now I shall annex this land here. This area is rich in resources and tactically vital. I will take it. The natives here are going to assist us. I have fought the natives before, and they were redoubtable enemies. they will be equally redoubtable friends. I will form a French-Indian alliance. A trade post can be as strong a weapon as a fortress. Trade brings wealth, and wealth power. I need money to expand my economy. Trade will do the trick. I go now to raid their settlers. I am going to kill off some enemy settlers to slow their economy's growth. Now that my explorer has been rescued, his labors will benefit us both. Excellent! You have saved us from the cost of a ransom. Aha! Thanks to you, my explorer is back in action. Alas, I need my explorer and we could not rescue him. So I paid a hefty ransom. At least he is back now. I had to pay through the nose to get my explorer back. If only we could have rescued him. Bravo! My men have rescued my explorer. My explorer is back on his feet and ready for action. The enemy now has native allies. We shall have to fight all the harder. We need to fight natives as well as our main enemy. Keep training that army of yours. The fools! This enemy town is completely defenseless. Let us take advantage. Strike quickly, before the enemy realize how vulnerable this town is. Our enemy has stuck his neck out. Here is a town with no barracks. Send in the cavalry. He cannot reinforce this town with infantry. Take advantage of it. Attacking this town with artillery would be easy. He has no stable to produce cavalry. I wonder why he has not built a stable near here. Let us take advantage of his oversight at once. The enemy has killed my explorer. Perhaps a quick patrol could catch and kill the troops that did this. My explorer was overbold and has paid the price. My explorer has been slain. Yours must do double duty from now on. My explorer has been killed by the wildlife. The wilderness dangers seem more lethal than our enemy. My explorer lies bleeding his life out, and he was not even taken down by the enemy. Now my explorer is hors de combat. This is not an auspicious beginning. How pitiable, calling upon the natives of this land for help. This is a terrible place to build a town, as I will soon demonstrate. My brilliant scouting techniques have spotted your town's center. Soon the invasion shall begin. Towns so near to each other mean you will eat up all the nearby resources all the sooner. Your skill in managing your town impresses me. I hope you have not done so too soon. You advance with breakneck speed, I see. That should give us a tactical edge on our common enemy. Excellent! Now that you have the technological edge, press your advantage. Every time you get a treasure like that, it is good for both of us. What do you think you're doing? Shouldn't you be an edge or two higher by now? I have been in the next age for what seems like hours. When will you follow suit? I see you run your economy effectively. I am confident you will prove as good at warfare, no? That was fast! I suspect it bodes well for the future of our alliance. It's about time you managed to reach the colonial age with the rest of us. Finally! It took you long enough to get here to colonial. I see your colony is still in the early stages of construction. Will you be able to withstand more advanced enemy armies? The enemy will not wait for you to get to colonial. They'll attack when they are ready, not when you are ready. These discoveries are fascinating. I must make more of them. Our scholars in the Sorbonne will welcome the chance to study such things. Yes, gathering riches will advance our cause. You can take that treasure. I wasn't going to get to it until later. Please be careful about where you gather your treasures in the future. I will take care of those near my own town. Keep up the good work. How fine. Already gathering your first treasures. A fine job in making discoveries. Do not neglect your town's development, however. It is good to see you have so many treasures. You have not let your economy lag, I trust. Can you not find the treasures scattered around the landscape? There are treasures here, there, and everywhere. Are you blind? I realize this discovery was rather near to your town, but it will go to a good cause. Thank you for the treasure. You will need to make discoveries on your own for a time, I fear. My explorer is indisposed. I regret to report that my explorer was a bit too bold.
He's dead.
Now my forces are advanced far beyond your primitive imagination. You have fallen into my trap, advancing to colonial too soon. Did you wake up at last, or were you stimulated to age up by some kind of primeval instinct?
You are doing well, I see. Please stay in the Discovery Age for as long as possible, preferably the rest of the game.
You have nothing better to do but look for loot. I cannot waste my efforts on picking up random treasures. I have a war to win.
You must not be very good at multitasking. I see that you have been unable to both gather nuggets and try to build your town. I think this treasure now belongs to me.
I regret I do not currently have sufficient resources to help you. My resources are almost gone. I cannot do what you've requested.
My sincerest apologies, but I cannot help at this time.
I do not have any soldiers yet. I am working on other issues at this time, so I do not have an army. I have not yet taken the step of creating an army. I do not have sufficient men under arms. They would just be killed to no avail. My army is not ready to fight. My small army would make no difference in the fight. You'll have to do it yourself until I have built up more strength.
Certainly. I shall comply immediately.
Well thought out. I regret that I am not allowed to take that step. It is impossible for me to do as you wish. Yes, I agree. Artillery backed by cavalry it is. You are right. Artillery plus infantry should seal our enemy's fate. Artillery is the god of the battlefield after all. The best generals will all artillerymen first. My cavalry can run amok. With some artillery pieces to back them up, we shall have a fine army.
Yes, if I train cavalry, perhaps even cuirassiers, and accompany them with some infantry, we shall see.
I love infantry. Their stolid, relentless nature brings out the best in my artillerymen as well. I shall train infantry, the queen of battle, with some horsemen to keep their flanks safe. I will train the cavalry component of our joint army. I see you have heard the reputation of the French cavalry. Soon they shall fight at your side. Infantry has many uses. I shall train as large a force as possible. Infantry have staying powers that other units lack. I shall field as many as you need. Now you have the economic edge over our foe. Use the gold wisely. An army travels on its stomach. It is good you found food. What a creative way to add to your army. We need wood, as much as steel and shot. I will take all of these I can get. I can use this coin to pay my soldiers. Food to feed my soldiers. Free soldiers are always good for the soul. More wood, more buildings. I never doubted my eventual victory in that fight. The enemy soldiers gave it their best shot, but it was not enough. Did you watch that fight closely? You can learn something from my skill as a commander. All too easy. I thought I would win, and I did. I wish the enemy would present more of a challenge. The best offense is a good defense. Walling in my main base will free up more troops for the attack.
Keep calm. All we have to do is knock out one of the enemy posts, and all will be well.
We need to organize for an assault on one of the four enemy posts as soon as possible. We have them by the nape of the neck. If they cannot break through our defenses, they are done for. Do not relax your vigilance. The enemy will be desperate now. Congratulations are in order, I see. Your multiplayer rating has skyrocketed since we last met. How impressive. Your multiplayer score is much higher than before. I see your multiplayer score has dropped since our last session. Well, watch what I do and learn. Your multiplayer rating is so low. I will try to teach you what I can, but it's up to you to apply it in battle. I am happy to see you have been building your skills and experience since we last met. I applaud you for increasing your home city's size so much since last time. Something about this map seems familiar to me. Our last fight alongside one another was a bit of a fiasco. I am sure we will turn it around this time. Remember what you did last time we played? We lost. So don't do that same stuff. Remember what you did the last time we played? We won. So do the same things. I promise to do better than last time. Try to improve on your past skills, please. I went easy on you when we fought each other last time. Now that we are allies, I'm pulling out all the stops.
So now you seek me as an ally instead of a foeman. That is wise. This is quite irksome. I guess we will have to seek victory the old-fashioned way. Even though the enemy has already allied with the natives, we still have a little time before he can make that alliance effective. We must move quickly and decisively. The enemy now has natives, unlike us. We can only hope this alliance has overstretched them. The enemy now has a trading post. I trust this means they will be emphasizing their shopkeepers instead of their military. The enemy may have overstretched their resources, building that trading post so soon. Though the enemy has more native villages on his side, we should be able to keep up with his numbers by diligently training our troops. Why is our enemy building so many trading posts? What are they thinking? With these extra natives, we can outfight and outtrain our enemy. More trading posts means more money, which can be turned into a bigger army. We have natives now, and the enemy does not. I am glad to see you are keeping an eye on the trading post sites. Well, I have stopped their victory countdown. Now they will probably resort to other means. As expected, I have claimed the first native village. It is only logical that I should claim a trade route first. Every trading post we build brings us closer to economic triumph. I do not fear the outcome of this fight. Even at a higher difficulty level than our last combat, we should win. We do not have much of a challenge ahead of us, now that you've turned down the difficulty. There is no time to waste. Throw everything you have at the enemy trading posts, or we are done for. Victory is all but assured now. They have but 1 minute to stop us, and I do not think they can do it. A single minute, then the laurels of victory will be ours. There is no hope for us now, my friend. I have let you down. Let us surrender while we still have a little dignity. These natives will no longer serve the purposes of our enemy. That is the end of that town. Let us move on to the next. He no longer has the use of that town. It is in our hands. Now that we have captured this area, should we build our own trading site here? That base was too well fortified. We will need a stronger army. That village was surprisingly difficult to take down. His town has foiled us. For now, we must try harder in the future. That trading post further strengthens our opponent every minute. Why do you fight on? The case is hopeless. If you do not surrender soon, I may do so on my own. Coin, your war chest can use this, can it not? The French have the finest cuisine in the world, my friend. Take these rations and see for yourself.
Wood may not be as exciting as coin or food, but it is still necessary. Take this for your coffers. I cannot do as you request. The critical place we must help is this spot here. I need your assistance. Kindly send troops to this point as soon as possible. My soldiers are already en route. I am going to reinforce you here. In my opinion, we need more men here. I am sending them right now. I will be there as soon as possible. You will not lose here. I have sent a corps to back you up. Keep it up. Soon my men will arrive and the jaws of the trap will close on the enemy army. I have assigned a sufficient force to defend this building. None shall pass. I will keep this native village out of the enemy's hands. The enemy should not take this town. I will guard it. This would be a dangerous spot for the enemy to build on. I will protect it. Tell me when you no longer need the extra coin, and I will stop sending it. Food cooked by French chefs. Tell me when you need no more. Let me know when I have sent enough wood to you. I am pleased to have an ally worthy of my prowess. I need some coin right now. I vow it will go to good use. Please, send me some coin if at all possible. I need food badly. An army travels on its stomach. Can you ship me some food? Without wood, how can I build an empire? Do you have some wood you're not using? Ship me some wood, now! Please. They are doomed. Already I can taste victory. Their soldiers are too few and too badly managed. I sense victory. See how the enemy line is already beginning to crack under my troops' hammer blows. I could have done it without your assistance, but you did save me some time. Working together, we were able to save my base. Perhaps I could have saved my base alone. We shall never know. A few more victories like this, and our foe will be undone.
This is just the way I won the Battle of Austerlitz. Let us take a brief breather, then return to the fray once more. This coin will be put to good use. This is just what I needed. This food is almost as good as my own chefs could cook. This wood comes at a most opportune time. You must be able to recognize a defeat well ahead of time, so that you can keep it as minimal as possible. Pull back at once. The enemy is too strong here. With artillery, war is made. You have a lack of these basic means, my ally. Cavalry is the answer to our problems. Equip some horsemen, and we can ride down the enemy. Your army is unbalanced. You need more horsemen to balance the rest of your forces. Infantry is the queen of battle. You have too many kings and not enough queens. Infantry is the backbone of any army. Your army, my friend, is practically spineless by comparison. The situation does not look good, my friend. Perhaps we should make a dignified retreat and resign this game. This time they have proven the stronger force. Perhaps we will defeat them next time. Shall we resign now? A soldier will fight long and hard for a bit of colored ribbon. You know, a throne is only a bench covered with velvet. Death is nothing. To live defeated is to die daily. Attack! Down with you, vile enemy. Now you should begin to understand just how badly you have blundered. Your men are doomed. Can't you train your own? Hired up for gold? Are your folks starving that you would waste time looting that? Can't train your own soldiers so you recruit them from the wilderness? Wood is in the trees, not laying around the ground. More settlers means a bigger economy, which means a stronger army. Too bad for you. Wealth is the blood of nations. More rations for my ever-growing forces. More warriors for my army, and free ones at that. Wood is good for natives, artillery, and necessary buildings. Free wood is best. Can't you put up a better fight? That battle was rather trivial. I kept hoping you had an interesting surprise up your sleeve, but no. Is that it? I guess it was too much to expect for you to pull off a win with those odds against you. This war might be more interesting than I had predicted. Nice job. I'll have to change my strategy, I see. Your multiplayer rating is much higher. I hope this means you will present an interesting challenge for me. I see your multiplayer rating has plummeted since our last encounter. Well, watch carefully what I do and perhaps you'll learn something. I've been idle for so long. Thanks for letting me have another chance to meet you. Are you in a rut? This is the same kind of countryside as the last time we played. This is going to be harder for me than the last time we met. I respect an opponent who is willing to take on a tougher challenge than he did last game. My hat is off to you. Cunning of you to use map control and four trading posts to try for a victory. It won't work, however. You may have access to more native warriors for now, but soon the situation will be altered in my favor. You have spread yourself thin on the trade routes. I can take keen advantage of this. The problem? Too many enemy trading posts. The solution? Elimination. Problem solved. The natives don't want your burdensome rule. They'll be much better off under my burdensome rule. This is a decisive blow at your very heart. This time your trading post. Next time your whole empire. With these native warriors assisting me, I can swamp you with numbers. You are remiss, my friend. This trading post will boost my power and lead to my ultimate win. I suppose those walls might delay the inevitable for a few short minutes. The money you're wasting on those walls would have been better used to beef up your army. I had marked those natives as my allies. I must do something about the situation. I think by building that trading post, you have stretched your resources just a little too far. I did not need that particular native alliance anyway. It is most annoying, but I can survive without that trading post. For now. You think this will stop me? It just steals my resolve. Don't think this ends the threat to you. Of course, I always fight to the best of my ability. But now that you have increased the difficulty, my ability has risen accordingly. Beware. Couldn't take the higher difficulties, eh? Decided to turn it down a notch? Now the burden for action is on your shoulders. All I have to do is keep a firm grip on my trading posts, and it's all over.
Just 1 minute.
Wait! Surely you don't want it to end this way. Demolish one of your trading posts, quick! Let us end this with a bang, not a whimper. You fools! You thought you could defeat me? Now I am only seconds from winning. Even over something as trivial as that treasure, I am able to give your soldiers a sound drubbing. You'll need more soldiers than that to attack my town. Your troops are out in the open, exposed. Now that I can see where your explorer is headed, I know your entire plan. You stand no chance against my skilled legions. Surrender now. This fight is going to be complicated. That will give me a natural advantage. Sometimes it is good to look to our defenses, such as walls. I see you have walled off your base. I considered it myself. Ha ha! Perfidious Albion will soon be no more. Those cursed beefeaters are proving difficult for our troops to overcome. Will it be another Waterloo? I never did think the Dutch would offer much of a threat. The wealth and power of the Dutch are giving them disproportionate strength. Très bien! We now know who is best suited to rule the French nation. The enemy French are nearly as strong as mine. This could be a problem, my friend. Germany was my battlefield and playground for many a year. History repeats itself. These Germans seem strangely effective in combat. Too effective. One Turk can beat 3 Frenchmen, but 10 Frenchmen are a match for 10 Turks, and 100 Frenchmen can defeat any number of Turks. The Ottomans have always been a powerful enemy. One for one, they may be the strongest soldiers in Europe. So much for the vaunted Portuguese. I'd wondered what they would be like to fight. Mere pushovers. The Portuguese are proving stalwart opponents. There must be something we can do about them. The Russians are almost gone. I wish I had you by my side when I marched on Moscow in 1812, my friend. The Russians are proving as stubborn here in the New World as they did in the Old. The Spanish never could stand up to good French firepower. Spain proved an annoying problem to me in 1807 through 1814. History seems to be repeating itself. The enemy is too strong for me at this time. Please, send help at once. They have somehow overcome my forces. My weakness may now prove your Achilles heel. I fear I have met another Waterloo at the hands of the hated British. The enemy has us on the defensive. Perhaps we can at least destroy the perfidious British. I wish the Dutch had been on our side, instead of opposed to us. My advice is for us to try to take out the Dutch player. Annihilate him, and we could turn this war around. The French are, as always, redoubtable. In fact, I think they have beaten me soundly. I no longer have confidence in our ultimate victory. But for now, the enemy French are vulnerable to a counterattack. I do not like our prospects, but I think the Germans are the enemy's weak point. You have betrayed our cause. I would have won if you had not dragged me down with your floundering. So, your ineptitude has brought me to this pass. Now it looks as though we might lose. The Ottomans are so numerous and so wealthy that I see nothing we can do to turn the tide. The Turkish Empire is tottering. Let us take them down with us. The Portuguese have long been my enemies. It seems I cannot hold them off much longer. The Portuguese have long been my enemies. Before we give up, let's strike at them. They may prove to be the weak point in our opponent's defenses. The Russians are stronger than we. History repeats itself. I perceive a weakness in the Russian foe. We may possibly be able to get out of our predicament by focusing on them and knocking them out of the war. I am stunned that the Spanish, of all people, are proving the masters. The weak opposing Spanish are like an ulcer in our enemy's side. Let us take advantage of their feebleness and destroy them. We may yet win this war. We did not defeat them quickly enough. We gave them time to summon reinforcements, and that could be our undoing. We had the victory won, but now there are more of them. Do you have any reserves you could send? It is good that your troops have come to help mine. A little longer and who knows what could have happened. I might even have lost. I was worried about the outcome of this fight, but your men seem to have come in time to save my forces. Merci, my friend. As I predicted, we are masters in this struggle. The enemy has not proven able to cope with us. Now our combined forces will finish him off. The enemy's incompetence has led him to this pass. We need only to keep doing what we have been doing so far to let victory fall into our hands. The enemy is falling behind me. I wish you would catch up. I realized that I could have beaten the enemy by myself, but still there was no need to put it to the test. There is still time for you to rally your forces and participate in the final crushing of the foe. Surely you don't want me to have all the glory. You are doing a terrific job, my friend. I shall strive to live up to your example. Move onward to victory. I shall assist you as much as possible. Your powerful army and economy have led our alliance to the verge of victory. You are a great leader. I had you in the grasp of my hand. Do not think that just because your ally managed to save you this time, that he would be able to do it every time. Seeking refuge under your ally's protective cloak? That won't work forever, you know. You clearly do not comprehend the value of combining your forces, and it's going to cost you this fight. I could have defeated you alone, but my ally wished to join in the spoils. Too bad for you. The fact that you have joined up will help you no more than it helped my enemies at Austerlitz. And even better than at Austerlitz, now I have allied troops assisting me. You have fallen into our trap. Your armies grouped together will now be shattered by our armies grouped together. This will be one of my most glorious triumphs. With the bounty of the new world at my disposal, nothing can stop me. My men plunder the countryside for my glory. Wherever I turn, I find riches to aid the French cause. Pathetic! Foraging in the forest like a hungry peasant. Grubbing in the dirt again. How sad for you. I see your explorer is out frantically accumulating random odds and ends. Your settlers must be very inefficient. Oh, already reduced to foraging. Your settlers must be starving. Skill in exploration will not help you in battles to come. You have accumulated almost no treasure. I had hoped for a more worthy opponent. Ah, the foolishness of an inexperienced leader, wandering so far from reinforcements. You'll pay for stealing that treasure, and soon. Ha! You fool! Can't you even collect the treasure near your own town? You still have not advanced in age? The situation would be laughable if it were not so serious for you. Advancing at this breakneck speed cannot be good for you in the long run. And that is when I will crush you. Finally, signs of life. Perhaps it will at least look like I had a challenge. Impressive technology. But can you do anything with it? Enjoy your brief edge over me while you can. Huh. Wasting your resources on bells and whistles, I see. Edging up so early is a frivolity I cannot afford. I have found you. All that remains is to fly a French flag over that town. You build near your ally. A sound strategy. Now I can annihilate you both. You build far from your ally's support. Because you are bold or simply foolhardy. My explorer is free. If you'd paid attention, you could have demanded a ransom. My explorer has slipped through your clutches. Your grip is too weak, my friend. My explorer has escaped. I see. You cannot train troops, so you borrow them. I see your puny army. I guess a stealthy approach is beyond your limited capacity. Your army is so small and quaint. It almost seems a pity to wreck it. A tiny little army. How cute. Now that I see your troops, I know what your plan must be. Still letting your army wander aimlessly, I see. I'm sure your men wish they had a more capable commander. You have lost the element of surprise. If I were a lesser man, I might even be afraid. However did you come up with an army so large? Your army is nowhere near my base. Do you know where you're taking it? Worthwhile technique trying to undercut my economy. More sophisticated than I would have expected from you. While you waste precious time chasing down my settlers, my invasion army readies. Stop that! Soldiers are meant to fight other soldiers. not civilians. You lack finesse, yet you are somehow effective. Perhaps I have underestimated you.
Sacre bleu! Your forces, so lethal! I demand a rematch! I do not understand what went wrong. My unworthy subordinates must be to blame.
Another battle, another day without a challenge.
Vive l'Empereur! Once more, French troops under my control prove victorious.
If you were more cunning, I'd worry about what you are planning. Skilled commanders do not give their opponents a chance to rest. Thanks for the respite.
There is no time to waste. Throw everything you have at the enemy trading posts, or we are done for. Just 1 minute. Wait. Surely you don't want it to end this way? Demolish one of your trading posts, quickly. Let us end this with a bang, not a whimper. Victory is all but assured now. They have but 1 minute to stop us, and I do not think they can do it. This is quite irksome. I guess we will have to seek victory the old-fashioned way. You fools! You thought you could defeat me? I am now only seconds from winning. Well, I have stopped their victory countdown. No doubt they will resort to other means. Do not think this ends the threat to you. The problem? Too many enemy trading posts. The solution? Elimination. Problem solved. Keep calm. All we must do is knock down some of the enemy posts, and all will be well. The trade monopoly timer has been started. Perhaps you can help protect what is rightfully ours. Do not relax your vigilance. The enemy will be desperate now. Clever of you to use map control and a trade monopoly to try for a victory. However, it will not work. Now the burden for action is on your shoulders. All I have to do is keep a firm grip on my trading posts, and it is all over. The Aztecs must not be feeling well to have fought so poorly. The Iroquois did not have the technology to oppose us. A little more pressure on the Sioux, and they will surely concede this campaign. We have traveled too far to allow the Aztecs to become so powerful. The Iroquois look formidable. We should concentrate an attack on them. I am not sure what all their dancing is about, but it seems to make the Sioux strong. We should have found a way to ally with the Aztecs. This is the first time I have seen the Iroquois so dangerous. How can we be losing to the Sioux? If we can take out the remaining Aztec army, there will be one less foe to worry about. Before we are overrun, let us take out the puny Iroquois. The Sioux are weak. Maybe we should have finished them off.